So the Whole 30 diet, I don't feel like as many people doing this now, but still is around and it crops up every now and then. So this was developed as an elimination diet to help people figure out basically how your physical, how foods were affecting your physicality and your mental health. So basically for 30 days, you would eat only fruit, vegetables, nuts, and meat. And all of the things not allowed would be oats, dairy, sugar, grains, and alcohol. So once people sometimes see the alcohol, they're like, oh, forget that. Like, I need my wine every night or whatever it is. So, you know, for a lot of people that kind of reset their body in a 30-day period, some people are fine that, oh, well, I'm not really having sugar. I don't really crave it anymore. You know, your taste buds have memory. So you like and dislike, which is why we dislike and dislike certain foods. However, when you are so used to eating certain foods every day, and you're doing this for 30 days, sometimes people stop missing the sugar, the alcohol. They sort of feel maybe a little better. If you're not drinking alcohol, you might sleep a little better, in which case it will have a positive physical effect, a positive mental health effect. So a lot of this, you know, works for some people. It is, again, it's restrictive. It's not as realistic, so it's a little hard to sustain for prolonged periods of time. And so, again, omitting certain food groups can, you know, cause or lead to some vitamin mineral deficiencies.